We've got your entree covered. Now it's time for dessert. So how does this sound? Wine poached pears.
Mm.
Yes.
Come on, louder. More enthusiasm.
Yes, we like this idea.
Yeah, and it's nice because pears work so well with cheese. So this is poaching wine, poaching pears in wine, and then mixing ricotta and parmigiano. It's really simple.
Mm.
So we're gonna start.
Okay, how do you do it?
We're gonna add some wine. I have to be very clear with Tracy, wine in the pot.
And do you really want the wine in the pot right now?
Well, if it was up to you and I, I'm sure we would. So wine in the pot and, yeah. Hey, it's
you working. tell me when to
keep
stop.
Keep going the whole bottle.
Oh, okay. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a daytime show.
Well, it is. Well, you know what? It's drunken pears.
Absolutely.
So we got to get them drunk.
Absolutely. And so sugar.
Put the whole bottle in there.
And I eyeball it.
Do you care what wine you use, by the way?
You know, a dry wine is good because then we're adding good wine. You always cook with good wine.
Yes, I've heard both sides of that argument. Some people say, no, I use the wine that I would never drink for cooking.
No, 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 it's going in.
And
it's
then
going,
I hear other people say, if I would not drink it, I will not cook
Absolutely.
With it.
Absolutely. Right? Okay, so we have the sugar in the wine, and now this is something that, you know, when you go away, you always kind of steal and kind of use and all the rest of it.
Yeah.
Spices. I mean, in Zanzibar, the spices were so amazing.
Mm-hmm.
So in...
They would just take a dish and take it to a next level,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, so, and now pears. These have been cut. They go right in. Now, this is going to come to a boil.
Okay. Do you have a favorite pear you like to use?
Bosque pears are really good,
okay.
These little things, because they keep the integrity when you've cooked them for about 30 minutes. Now, what you want to do is you want to cook the wine down with the sugar and the spices, the cinnamon, and it's going to give amazing fragrance to the house. If you ever want to sell your house, do this dish. I mean, it's like, it is amazing, you know, just, and it's like, wow, we'll buy it, and we'll
boil
get some
pears.
Boil
this up on the day of the open
Absolutely.
House.
Absolutely. Now, I'm going to do a quick ricotta. So this is just cow's milk ricotta.
Okay.
All in. And then, Tracy, do you want to help?
No, but you know I will.
It's okay. We'll just add lots of parmigiano. Now, what I love about ricotta and parmigiano, you actually just kind of play
is that
off.
It's cheese times two?
Well, cheese times two, but you have the saltiness from the parmigiano, and then you have the creamy kind of almost neutral flavor of the ricotta.
But that's what I love about ricotta, though. It has such a neutral flavor that it's so easy to pair with so many different things.
Absolutely.
And the parmesan is going to give it a punch.
And now we're just going to mix it. Let me just
get your tools.
Yeah, just going to mix it. So you can put equal parts parmigiano and ricotta. So think of pear and cheese, you know, as a dessert.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now you're actually just giving it a whole different spin.
Okay. How long does this usually take to come to a simmer?
About 30 minutes. Well, it comes to a boil in about, you know, 5-10 minutes.
Yeah.
And then after you want to reduce it.
And you're going to keep it on there for about a half an hour.
Yeah.
Because you want those flavors to really get into the pear.
And you also want to reduce it by about, you want to leave about a third of the liquid.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, that takes a while.
Yeah. And you also want to add some orange peel.
Okay. A little bit of citrus.
Yeah. And so we're just going to get, how are we doing for time? We're good?
Oh, we're fine.
Okay, good. Never know with these
I just want to see.
I can breathe a bit.
Yeah, no, yeah. You can take your time.
So
it's a very big difference between taping. I know you're the show that you are shooting all over the world. It's like you're taping pieces, so you can always
it's totally
in editing.
Different, right? It's like,
it's
okay,
totally
we'll
different.
Fix that in post.
Right?
Can we fix this in
There's
post?
There's no post here.
No.
I want post.
Absolutely. Post is amazing. Although live television is so fun.
Yeah,
right?
Well, it is because you just kind of got to roll with it,
yeah.
Right?
So now, so you have the parmigiano and the ricotta.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, this is such a simple dessert, and it's fun, it's elegant, and you just...
I would actually just eat that.
You know what? I have.
It looks so good.
Right.
Okay, I was wondering how you were going to play it.
Yeah, and then you're just going to add some zest and a little bit of the reduced wine. And that's it.
And that's it.
Yeah,
you
so
have a dessert
a great
made
dessert,
in heaven.
And you can sell your house really easy.
Absolutely. You know, we were talking about your show, the show that you tape, and traveling with your whole family
mm-hmm.
everywhere. The next place you're going to hit is Asia.
Asia. We're going to Hong Kong, Singapore.
So I was asking, is it tough at all? For me, I didn't even used to love having my kids come down to the show because I'm trying to be hosting a show and I'm trying to be a mom, and that's tough. For you, you're shooting all of these episodes of your show, but then you're also a dad with your kids and your wife there. It's hard to balance all that, is it not?
Well, in Nairobi, we had some issues, and I was out early, 6 a.m., back home, back in the hotel, really late. And my kids were saying, Daddy, we haven't seen you in 3 days.
Right, and we're on vacation.
We're on vacation. Well, they're on vacation, we're working. And,
yes.
But, you know, the flip side is they're seeing things that, you know, they would never see before.
I tell my kids that all the time. So the flip side is look at the experiences you get to have.
It's amazing.
We're going to put a little bit of lemon zest on that.
Yeah.
We're putting the recipe online, cityline.ca. It looks like a dream, David. So good. Beautiful.
And so good for, like, summer alfresco dining.
Yes.
And literally, guys, it takes, like, 20 minutes.
Absolutely. Yeah. Looks great.